What's up, everybody? It's Davon Nelson. Good morning, Grand Rising. Listen, I'm not gonna be long. I'm actually getting ready. I'm up early here in Arizona. It's gonna be the last video that I do here in Arizona for a while, unless we get invited back. But real quick, I want to talk to you about the value of time. I think the season and the time that we are in now, I think understanding the value of time is important. And the reason being, you gotta understand that people who have information and experience, they go through stuff to obtain that information and to get that experience. You know, they fail many, many times to get that experience. They made many, many sacrifices to obtain the information and the knowledge and the wisdom and the understanding behind whatever it is that they are doing. Don't believe me? Ask some of the most successful people and, you know, listen to what they would tell you, how many times they failed, but nevertheless, they succeeded. And plus, those people understand the value of time. Now, saying that, if I'm not mistaken, I think Oprah, I posted this a while back, but I think Oprah gets like $500,000 just to speak for an hour. Now, when you understand the concept behind becoming a person of value, instead of just being famous or being well known or getting so many likes on social media, when you become a person of value, then you can place value on your time. Now, you don't have to be on Oprah's level to be a person of value, but a person of value is somebody that has been through something that somebody else haven't, and they have a different perspective about certain obstacles, and they have a certain outlook about whatever it is that they went through, and then they came out on the other side of. Only that person can tell you, you know what I'm saying, amongst anybody else that has went down that path. So therefore, they become people of value. So they place value on their time. So those people, you won't be able to just inbox freely and get a genuine response from them. And nothing is wrong with that. When you start to elevate like that, and you have to put a team in place to handle things like that. You know what I'm saying? So you won't get that person straight up. But if you have a person that you can easily reach out to, and they are valuable, you know, because they have been through some things that has qualified them and given them the credentials that's needed to be classified as valued. But they have been through something. So they understand and see some stuff. So, but if you can get access to those people, you gotta value their time. You know, too many times we want to reach out and get information from people, but we don't want to value their time. That part goes out the window. We don't want to value their time. We want for us. So we overlook that, hey, I might be reaching out to this person and it might be 8 o'clock at night and they stopping and taking time to talk to me. So, you know what I'm saying? So you don't see behind the scenes what everybody is doing. So, but if you are reaching out about something, you want some information about something, you know, it's plenty of other people that you can reach out to. Some people, they gonna charge you because they value their time. Some people, they gonna have a kind heart. Now, the thing with the person with the kind heart, don't take advantage of that person. If that person is taking time out of their busy schedule to stop and talk to you and give you some type of advice through life, you got to understand, you got to cultivate that relationship, you got to nurture it, and you got to value that relationship, because you don't see what type of priority that person places on you. When you send them a message, they stop everything they're doing and send a message back. You got to value that. If you don't value that, if you don't reciprocate that reciprocity, if you don't reciprocate that, then the relationship is not going to last. Even in a marriage, if, like, fellas, marriage tip, fellas, your wife is like a bank. And when you understand that you can only withdraw what you put in, you'll understand give and it shall be given unto you. You got to put in what you want to take out. You know what I'm saying? So if it's time and advice that you want, you gotta reciprocate that once you get it. You know what I'm saying? Like, you can't expect to get a person of value to just drop everything they're doing every single time. It don't work like that. But you should be willing to do stuff out of the kindness of your heart without even knowing that there is a reward for what you are doing. You know, see, me, I got this thing where I will ask somebody if they can do something for me. Now, granted, they've come to me multiple times wanting advice, and I've stopped, and I've made it a priority to give advice, to help when I can, taking time out of my day, my schedule, to help. And when that's not appreciated or valued, then this is what happens. Me and my wife can vouch for this. I got this thing where I would ask somebody who has, come to me and ask for advice. I ask them if they could help me with certain things. Now, if you can't, I appreciate the fact if you pick up the phone or send a message and say, hey, I can't do this. I will appreciate that. But if you don't do none of that, and you don't message, you don't communicate, you don't say anything, like, that right there, to me, is a slap in the face, because you don't see it valuable enough for you or beneficial for you. So, you don't want to do it, but you're not going to say it. It's just going to be a bunch of excuses why you can't do it. Now, what people fail to realize is, this is where you have to know me and my wife. If anybody that knows us, we are givers, and we don't mind giving, and if you help us out, we don't mind compensating. But you have to know us to know that. So therefore, anybody that knows us know that if me or my wife come to you and ask you to do anything, you already know at the end of that, you're going to be compensated. So you don't even have to ask, because that's who me and my wife is. Now, if you don't know that, you're not going to know that you're going to get compensated very well if me and my wife come and ask you for anything. You know, so the same value, this is where reciprocity comes in, the same value and priority that is placed on you when you are in need of advice, it should be reciprocated back. That's how you keep things going. You know, that's how you keep a network flowing. You know, if you think about a human body, if you get a blood clot somewhere, that's it. You know, that can be dangerous. That means it's a clog somewhere and nothing can't flow. So that's how it is with a business relationship, whatever. If you're not reciprocating, then it's clogging up. It's messing up the flow. So you got to understand the value of time and why people do and say the things that they do. You know what I'm saying? It's because they value their time. You can't just want to come and get an hour from a person. That's an hour of a person's time, especially a person that's trying to run a business and do all this stuff. You know, like, you don't see behind the scenes. You just see what you want in that moment. You can't do that. So the next time you approach a person of value, appreciate that person. Because it ain't always about money. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's time. appreciate the people that take time out to make time for you. You got to appreciate them. If you don't, hey, to each his own. But that's the value of time. Man, I'm Davon Nelson. Y'all be blessed.